Hello everyone, this is Abdu Alkishe, postdoctoral, Department of Fish and Wildlife Conservation at Virginia Tech. Today I'm gonna give a very brief and broad explanation about ecological niche. So what you are going to get from this lecture is knowing the term of ecological niche, the differences between generalist and specialist animals, the differences between fundamental and realized niche, and understanding Hutchinson niche duality. So what's the ecological niche? So it's describing the role of organism plays in its environment. And as you see, like every animal has a role, for example, producing offspring or contributing in somewhat in its environment. So what can determine or be important to species to live? So abiotic factors, of course, are important. And those non-living factors as a temperature or precipitation, etc., have a very impact or direct impact on the presence of the species. Also biotic factors, example, interactions between different species, including prey species, competing species. So for each of these factors, species exhibit a range of tolerance. And we are going to talk about environmental tolerance or other factors. So for example, here, organisms can be identified as generalists, which means they have a broad niche and they have a lot of options, like not depending on one type of food, but they have a lot of options, a lot of sources. And living in many types of environments, and we have example here like house mice. So this species is very successful because, as you know, it can live anywhere in the field or inside houses. Specialists, organisms with the narrow niches. So in the bottom you see they are very narrow, they have a limited type of foods. They can't live with anything else. So they prefer some kind of foods and some kinds of habitat. So for example, here we have a panda bear. And as everyone knows, that type of species is restricted to some type of environments and eats just specific food. So what's the law of tolerance? In this example, the tolerance is abiotic factors, so that an organism has a range of tolerance within which it can survive. For example, this butterfly here has an optimal range, and the species is so abundant. But with a species like not a species, that environmental condition become like too hot or too low, for example, as a temperature, so few species can tolerance that type of temperature, but not all of them. Some individuals, sorry, here, and in this case they have a stress, or they called it physiological stress, where can some individuals resist and can survive, but it's not optimal for all individuals. Fundamental niche and realized niche. So For the fundamental niche, as you see in the figure here with a big blue circle or ellipsoid, so this indicates the total range of environmental conditions that are suitable for existing without the influence of interspecific competition or predation from other species. While the realized niche describes that part of the fundamental niche actually occupied by the species. To make it simple, imagine that you live in neighborhood. The neighborhood is your fundamental niche, but your house that you live inside and you do your functions, you do normal life, this is your realized niche. Here the example to make it simple also. So we have a different birds with different colors. So the tree is the fundamental niche where all they live on that tree, but each one prefers kind of a level on the tree. Now we are talking about Hutchinson niche duality. So duality means that there is no direct match between the topology of the niche space and the geographic distribution of the space. So here on the right, we have an example on environmental space where the P is precipitation and T is temperature. What I want to point it out here, we have different cities, and as you see here, Rio de Janeiro is the forest city, and it's really similar, it has very similar environmental condition to the pronounce the name of this city, but it has a similar condition to this one more than the upper one in the northern area. So what I want to point it out that it doesn't, or it's not necessary that two cities or two areas have a similar environmental conditions if they are close to each other. So in the bottom, another example that show you the fundamental niche and then realized niche in blue color and potential niche in different three colors. When we go to the geographic space on the right bottom, you see that observed distribution here where they have a species, also we have a similar environmental condition here, but there is no colonized species. So in general, this idea is telling us we have similar environmental conditions in different or on different geographic space. So is the niche stable? So no, it's not stable. It can be changed. So it depends on biotic interactions or environmental conditions or time of dispersal. So if we compare the biotic factor here, it used to be in this kind of shape, but with time too, it changed to be broader. So there is no stability in the niche through time, and that depends on different conditions, as I mentioned. In the end, thank you so much, and I hope I explained everything very well. Thank you.